The doctor's standing next to our 3D image, and he's going to show us now what a healthy spine is. So, doctor, I want to show our viewers the healthy spine and kind of explain the function of the spine. And I know it kind of has some natural curves as well that are supposed to be there.
Absolutely, Olga. So the lumbar curve, which, you know, this is an oblique image, but you could see that there's a bit of a C curve to the lumbar spine. The thoracic curve goes the other way. Cervical spine is just like the lumbar spine in what's called the lordotic posture. But there's something very important about this picture. Notice that the head is above the pelvis. I know this sounds like a, you know, what's so special about that, but actually think about that. If the spine starts to turn, the head will start to migrate away from the center axis. Now, it's very uncomfortable to walk with the head that's off center. And that goes both in the frontal plane as well as in the side plane. If you notice that our elderly patients walk with their head pitched forwards, biomechanically, that's not very favorable. So this goes back to Olga's original question. Why is kiddie scoliosis so different than adult scoliosis? And exactly as Roger mentioned, with kids, because the spine is so flexible above the curve, let's say this lumbar curve is significant, the thoracic curve can accommodate leaving the head above the pelvis. In our elderly population, where the spine loses some of its flexibility, if the spine curves significantly, biomechanically, it's very difficult to walk like this.